today. Marriage, that blessed arrangement, that dream within a dream world, true love.
5 hours later.
This video was made by the Colin Griffin and Luke Production Company and was made possible by viewers like you. Thank you. And that's where our story begins. In 19th century England, with two lovers on a cold winter's day. This is Charlie Baker. He's a steel mill factory worker with no particularly interesting qualities. He does not have any particularly interesting talents, nor an extremely well-paying job, but he does what he can, and he works hard to feed his family. This is Nicole Baker. She is married to Charlie Baker and also does not have any particularly interesting qualities. She works hard to help keep her husband happy, and she enjoys working with her family's spinning jenny. The year is 1860. Charlie and Nicole have been married for 2 years now. Their marriage is hanging by a thread. They can barely stand to be around each other for more than 5 minutes without fighting. Here comes Mr. Baker now, from his long day at the bustling steel mill.
Honey, I'm home.
Welcome home, honey.
Hey, what's cooking, good looking?
I've been slaving all day and I finally made your perfect meal. No crust, cut in rectangles.
Rectangles? Is that what you said?
Uh-huh.
Triangles. Nicole, I need triangles!
Well, you can fix it yourself!
It is important to note that the priest's words carry no meaning. Charlie and Nicole were never truly in love. Their marriage was more of an economic necessity than affection. Women at this time were unable to sustain themselves, so a young and foolish Nicole had paired up with a freak that preferred his sandwiches and triangles.
This whole wheat bread?
It's healthier.
It's 5 cents more.
Grape jam!
Honey, wanna go to the dinner tonight?
I just worked 23 hours in the steel factory.
You really think I wanna spend my 1 free hour with you?
I just feel like we don't talk that much.
Honey, have you ever thought about divorce?
All the time.
So why do you say that?
Well, without you, I'd be left to starve on the stormy streets. And frankly, I have no legal reason to divorce you at all. And while I would, they wouldn't believe me, even if I tried.
Well. That day, Mr. Baker thought of a plan so devious, so dastardly, that even the devil himself would look down upon it. He was going to tell the government his wife was having an affair.
Well, Mr. Baker? Thanks to the Matrimonial Causes Act implemented in 1857, which states that you have the right to divorce your wife on grounds of adultery, I think we have what we need to get this done. What do you say?
I am more than happy to divorce this witch.
Oh, and, Mrs. Gancourt. What a shameful, shameful thing you have put this wonderful man through.
Yeah, shame, shame.
Not long after that, there was no longer a Mr. and Mrs. Baker. There was simply Mr. Baker and Miss Nicole Dankworth. Nicole was cast to the streets, with nothing but the clothes she was wearing and her will to survive. Her parents lived 200 miles away, inaccessible unless by train, which she had not the money to afford. She searched far and wide looking for work, almost anything she could do to make some money. Most women would find a rich household to work at, as a servant, but Nicole was done making sandwiches. And then she found it. The perfect job.
Can I have a job? Absolutely.
For months, Nicole worked to please her boss and feed herself. No matter how hard she worked, she found obtaining the money she needed difficult. She would never be paid as much as a man, and she knew it. Some of the men at her work had formed a trade union, in which she was excluded.
Sir?
What's your face? Please, have a seat.
Listen, Mr. Henry, I've been struggling the past couple months, and I haven't been able to feed myself.
I'm gonna stop you right there, kiddo, love, darling.
5 hours later.
Hey, that dog won't hunt. So you can either take what I'm giving you now, or you can get out of here, and I can find someone else to do your job for you.
Sir.
What's your name?
Nicole.
All right, well, Nicole.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
You're fired. Get out. What are you looking at?
And so Nicole took to the streets, begging for money to try to afford the train ride to her parents' home. Let's just say, she never saw a sandwich again.
If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps, just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing. Things always look on the bright side of life. Come on! Always look on the bright side of life.
Strawberry!
For life is quite absurd, and death's the final word. You must always face the curtain with a bow. Forget about your scene, give the audience a grin. Enjoy it, it's your last chance anyhow. So old.